Hi to all. Today we will discuss of finding the path of the throwing object from one position to another position. So take one example. Here I am taking one object. I am throwing this object from first position to second position on the ground level. The throwing object is moving in this path. This path we are calling it is a parabola. So if you are dividing this path into two equal halves, whatever this distance, x1 distance, horizontal length, it is equal to the same length this side also. Okay, so here we will get the parabola. So in this method, we are doing the parabola by using the oblong method. In oblong method, we are taking one rectangle after doing this parabola path. Okay, this method we are using in oblong method. And here our question is little different. Let us take the question first. A stone is thrown from a 4 meters high building. Okay, one building is there on the ground. It is 4 meters height. One stone is throwing from that building. Okay. The stone just crossed the top of a 10 meters high tree from the ground. So on the ground one tree is there. This stone is crossing this tree, top of the tree, and it is falling on the ground. Okay, it is just whatever height of the tree it is, this stone is moving that height and then it is falling on the ground. Next given data is, if the horizontal distance between the building and the tree is 5 meters, the distance from building and tree is 5 meters horizontal distance. Here from the building to tree distance is 5 meters, okay, on the ground. And then find the distance of the point from the building where the stones falls on the ground. As I told, stone is falling on the ground. We need to find the distance from the stone to this building. Okay, horizontal distance we have to find. Okay, find the distance of the point from the building where the stone falls on the ground. Okay, x value we need to find. So for doing it, we have to do the parabola using oblong method. Here both first position and second position on the same ground. That's why we can do the parabola easily. Here the stone position is 4 meters height, okay, from the ground. What I am doing means, I am just dividing into two parts. I am taking whatever height, 4 meters height here. I am doing the parabola in this part. Okay, this is also 4 meters. Up to 4 meters, I will do the parabola by using oblong method. Okay, by constructing the box, we can do. This is 5 meters, it is given. And this is also 5 meters. As I told, whatever distance here, the same distance here also. So the remaining part, we have to find where the stone will fall by using this already existing parabola. Okay, first let us do this path, okay, parabola, by using the instruments. So what is this distance height of the parabola? Okay, this height. So here we know this height 4 meters. This is 10 meters. 10 minus 4 is 6 meters. We can write, take 6 meters height parabola. Okay, this is 4 already I told building height. And 10 minus 4 means 6 meters. Okay, first I will construct one box of dimension 6 meters by, this is 10 meters. Okay, let us do. First construct the box 10 meters by 6 meters. Okay, so here units are in meters. We can't do in the small paper in meters. That's why take scale. In it, consider 1 meter is equal to 1 centimeter. Okay, instead of 10 meters, I am taking 10 centimeter. Instead of 6 meters, I will take 6 centimeters. So we need to do the rectangle 10 centimeter by 6 centimeters. Okay, first do one line of 10 centimeters. So here I am doing 10 centimeter line. Mark the end points initially. So this is 10 centimeter line. I am giving end points A and B. And do the height 6 centimeters here and here. So it is 90 degrees at both sides. That's why I will take this as the reference line. From it take 6 centimeters. And then here also takes 6 centimeters for getting perpendicular 90 degrees I am using. Join these two ends. So give the end points AB already we have marked CD. After that divide this rectangle into two equal halves. Mark the middle point. In 10 centimeter, middle point is 5 cm. Here also mark the middle point. 10 cm, 5 cm. This middle point. Join these two points. And here give this is name is O and H. In the oblong method, we have to divide initially AO into some equal divisions. We can divide into 4 divisions, 3 divisions or 5 divisions, it is our wish. Here AO is, as we know, just now we did 5 cm. Okay, I will divide into 5 parts. Means each part is 1 cm. Let's take here 1 cm, mark 1 point. First point, second point, third and fourth. And just give the names 1, 2, 3, 4. So here we have divided first part, second part, third part, fourth part, fifth part. We have divided this half length, AO length into 5 divisions. Similarly, whatever divisions here we did, here also we have divided the same number of divisions. That is 5 divisions, 5 parts. So this height is 6 cm. We have to divide this 6 cm into 5 parts. So each part is calculated. So 6 divided by 5. We are getting it is 1.2 cm each part is. So by using scale, just take one take. Each part is 1.2 cm. Mark, this is the first one. And from here, 1.2. Or you can take 2.4, 3.6 like that also. 1.2. From here, 1.2. Okay, give the numbering, whatever numbering here, start with 1 dash, 2 dash like that. So 1 should come near each other. Here 1 dash, this point is 2 dash, 3 dash, and then 4 dash. Here after getting these numbers, join all these points to H with the help of scale. After getting these lines, from these points also do the lines, vertical lines. So at 1, do the vertical line extend up to 1 dash, first line. Do the vertical line at 2, extend up to 2 dash. Like that, extend up to that respective line. So I am using roller scale for doing the parallel lines. You, this point is P1. So 1 dash intersection point is P1. Similarly at 2, so here if we join A and P point and H, we will get half of the parabola. For the remaining half also, follow the same process. Divide this OB also 5 parts. Each part is 1 cm. Give the names here. And here also divide into 5 parts. As I told, it is 6 cm. 6 by 5 means 1.2 cm each part is. These points also give the numbering. This is 1 dash near to 1. This is 2 dash. This point is 3 dash. And then 4 dash. So join all these points to H. Do the vertical lines at all these points. Extend first line up to 1 dash. Second line up to 2 dash like that. Again I am using the roller scale. these points. Here I have given P1, here I am given P1 dash. This point is P2 dash, this point is P3 dash, this point is P4 dash. If we join all these P dash points through B and H, we will get remaining half of the parabola. Okay, let us join all these points by using the French curves. For joining all these points, I am using the French curve. Here we have to keep this curve which is passing through all the points. Join this point to A. Doing this side curve, just make it into reverse and keep this curve should coincide with these points. Now join this point to B. Now this is the parabola by using the oblong method. Now in the given question, we did this part. And we did this parabola. Now here we have to mark this height from the parabola. The building height is 4 meters. At 4 meters we have to do one horizontal line. Mark this 4 meters height with dotted line. So here take, so this is 4 centimeter. Mark this point is E point. At E we do the ground. It is, we will take in the dotted line. For doing the horizontal parallel line, I am taking roller scale, just at E do the ground line. So after getting this ground line, as I told, whatever object we are throwing, it is falling on the ground. The path is coming in the parabolic form. Okay, here we don't have any dimension for marking, for extending this arc. For getting this arc, here extend this line just for marking these points. And here also extend the line, marks the points here at these distances. Do the horizontal line. Here extend the line. We don't know up to how much distance. Just do one line here. Mark these points, one or two points on this side. So each division is here 1 centimeter. Okay, because we have divided this 5 into 5 parts, means each is 1 centimeter. So here also let us take 2 or 3 points at 1 centimeter distance. At 1 centimeter 1 point. Here I am taking 2 points. Okay. If you want, do the numbering also. Up to 4 we have given here. Take this is the 5th point and this is the 6th point. So similarly, here also extend the line, vertical line. So whatever distance points we are taking on the vertical line, take the 2 or 3 points here also. Here we took 2 points, here also take 2 points. So each point is 1.2 centimeter distance. This gap is 1.2. This side also I am taking 1.2 distance. And again one more point at 1.2 distance. Okay. Here I am giving, here 5, 6 I have given, here 5 dash and 6 dash. Okay. Why we have marked here means for getting the extended parabola. Okay. And here we extend this line up to the ground line. And after doing this line, here we have joined all vertical line points to H. So similarly, on these vertical line points, 5 dash, 6 dash also joined to H with the help of scale. After joining to H, so extend this line this side also, because we are getting the curve in this direction. So extend these lines up to some distance. Okay. And then at these points we did vertical lines. Here also at 5 and 6 do the vertical lines. Here I am using the roller scale. So at 5 extend the line up to 5 dash line. So this is point P5. 5th and 5 dash intersection point P5 dash. Similarly at 6 also do the line. Here 6th point is coming up to this on the ground line. Okay, but if we extend this line here, here we are getting 6 dash and 6 P6 dash. So here this is the ground EF I will take. If we extend this sixth one and the six dash line, it is coming below the ground, okay, this point. But our object is falling on the ground. Now only P5 dash is above the ground level. That's why we have to consider this point and extend this parabola up to P5 dash and extend up to ground. Okay, ground is EF. So use the French curve for joining the points on the curve, so that this B point and P5 dash point should come on the same curve. I'm extending this curve up to this ground level. Okay. And now here give the name of this sum T point. This is the complete path of the throwing stone. It is falling on the ground at T point on this ground line, EF line. Here what we have to find? Find the distance of the point from the building where the stone falls. We need to find this distance from building to the falling object distance. Okay. So to find horizontal distance traveling by the stone from this position to up to this ground level. So ET distance we have to measure. So horizontal distance traveling by the object, it is 11.5 centimeter. Just write down here the distance traveled by the object horizontally. ET is equal to 11.5. We have to, so here in this diagram I have marked all the lengths from the ground level. The building height is 4 meters. Okay. And the tree height is 10 meters, okay, from the ground level, and this distance is 10 meters. So here 5, so I have marked 5 meters, and ET distance already we have measured, it is 11.5 meters. So mark all the dimensions neatly, given dimensions and required dimensions. So this is the complete path of the stone falling from the building to the ground.